Norm first came to live with us 60 years ago. Norm's mother had passed away and his father was unable to take care of him. My dad was president at a Jewish family service and they had a foster child program.
I was looking for a six-year-old little girl and turned around and in came a 6'1", 165-pound string bean, and I was 110 pounds, 5'1", and I said, oh my God, what did I get into?
Norm fit in just like our own child and was a brother to our children.
Well, Norman and I had graduated from law school together, along with a fellow by the name of Jack Hyatt. And the three of us just decided that not only would we continue our friendship, we would continue a friendship with a partnership. Norm Brownstein has had impact in so many spheres of life.
Norm Brownstein has done as much for the city of Denver, the metropolitan area of Denver, for the entire state of Colorado, as any other single person.
Probably no one has done more for National Jewish Health than Norm. He's been responsible for helping us gain additional federal funding for a small institution to the tune of about $35 million or more over the past many years. And these funds have been crucial for the institution as we've done groundbreaking medical research, cared for patients without regard to their ability to pay.
Norm Brownstein and the Brownstein, Hyatt, Farber and Schreck law firm have been just tremendous stakeholders in our community. They truly care and have taken ownership and leadership in the city of Denver with regards to any project that we're pursuing.
I think it's fair to say that Denver International Airport would not exist today if it weren't for Norm Brownstein.
One of the reasons that he's been so successful is he never wants credit. He rolls his sleeves up, he gets to work, he knows who to call, puts together the right team, and then things happen.
His influence, his presence, and the respect that he has in DC keeps Denver plugged in. And as a result, we have a tremendous advantage. I call it the Norm Brownstein advantage.
There are those senators who attract crowds. So you'll see one of the great leaders of the Senate, and there'll be 20 people around them waiting to talk with them. And then there's Norm, surrounded by somewhere between 5 and 10 senators. He's a force of nature.
Norm has been a fixture in the pro-Israel community. He has developed relationships on Capitol Hill with Democrats and Republicans on behalf of the Jewish community and on behalf of the U.S.-Israel relationship. He really is one of the giant figures in the pro-Israel movement in America.
When I have a difficult decision on the Middle East, when I need to be well-informed, I call Norm all the time, and he is a dear and good friend who will give you the straight skinny.
He is held in incredibly high regard. He's also, at times, a little feared, because when he is on something and he's passionate about it, nothing stops him. And everybody in Washington, D.C. knows that, and they respect it.
We are very close friends, and there's not a week that goes by that he's not prepared to give me his advice on something. He's never shy about delivering that, or telling you when you're making a mistake, which is often the conversation that Norm and I have.
The fact that so much of the work that we've done in the United States Senate reflects the handiwork, the imprint of Norm Brownstein. And for that, I'm eternally grateful, and it's made our country and Israel stronger together.
He's a mensch. He smiles. He speaks with the cheretz, with respect. He loves the Jewish people, the state of Israel. He loves mankind.
He cares a lot about his home state of Colorado. He's clearly got a lot of friends, too. Just look all around you. Of all of his blessings, though, I think Norm would be most proud of his family, especially his wife, Sunny.
There's no question that in Norm's order of priorities, his dear Sonny and his family, children and grandchildren, are number one.
He has had such an influence, not only through his actions, but the actions that he has brought forth from others. And that will be lasting for years and years to come.
I'd like to join those in attendance tonight in recognizing Norm for this award.
I can't imagine someone who could deserve it more.
It's a privilege to honor you tonight. Congratulations on this great honor. The world is a better place for your leadership, your philanthropy, your friendship.
From your friend, from your mayor, and from someone who respects you tremendously. Congratulations.
Norm, to you and to Sonny and to the whole family, we're very proud of you. You may live in Denver, but you're at the service of the world Jewish community. Kol hakavod.
I am honored to join this evening in paying tribute to you on behalf of AIPAC for this remarkable contribution that you have made.
I'm proud of you. I've been for the 50 years we've been together. Nobody could have a better partner. Thanks for all you do.
You are such a force in so many of our lives. So thank you, and God bless you.
We're very proud of you, and we feel as lucky to have had you come to live with us. I hope you feel your work.
Norm, I can always look up to you.
Yeah,